started around October 22nd is when we heard about Figgy coming to this nice lady's backyard. She had seen him probably about 3 weeks before that.
About 4 months ago, I heard his voice, and I knew there was something different out there. There was a different bird. It's not the normal birds that came to my yard, a yodel of his. And I went outside every day, early in the morning, looking for him. And then the first time I saw that iridescent green body in my yard, I got so excited. Woman I worked with, she has a couple of birds, and she turned me on to Mickaboo.
So she contacted us, and we came out. I didn't see him for the first couple of days, so I didn't know exactly what kind of Amazon. He seems to really, really be buddies with the crows at first. That's why I affectionately call him the Green Crow. And they tolerated him very well. You see, provide some protection for him, so.
We'll scan at a good distance from those bare trees and he'll just watch to see if the coast is clear for him to come in.
Come a few times during the morning and the early afternoon, and then he'll come at night.
But I'm just happy I started feeding all the birds, and that's what brought Figgy to my yard.
Put out as much food in their feeders, so it'll get harder and harder for him to find the food he needs to keep going regularly and regularly. A lone parrot out here by himself, he just didn't stand a very good chance of surviving with them. He survived during that terrible windstorm that did a lot of damage to the area, so that was really good. That was really one of the good things that came out of that flyer. For information that he spent the whole time riding out the storm in someone's backyard. Taking cover in his trees. She knew he was different from all the wild birds. She could hear definitely. He was much louder. It's been a lot of cold early mornings sitting waiting to see him, but every day that we see him is a good day because we know he survived one more day. that keeps us going.
So I think whoever owned him really cut him a lot. But when he first came to the yard, he didn't have those long tail feathers, and he didn't have the dark wing feathers underneath. I will. I miss that sound when I don't hear it. In the mornings, I get really nervous if he's not around.
So in the weather, it's been very nice. Not as cold as it was during that cold windstorm that we had. We've had some very beautiful, nice, warm weather to keep him going.
It makes me sad.
He spends a lot of time on the wires. Wires out there just all by himself, all alone.
Did somebody abuse him and he was smart enough to escape and get away? He reacts very terrified to human beings. My little green crow, we call him the green crow. His crow buddies are gonna miss him. He was really, really happy when he was free. He was flying all over the place.
A bird like Figgy out in the wild has a very difficult time adapting when they don't have a flock to connect to. In addition to the dangers from predators, you also have the dangers from people who
and having somebody love him and having him bond with somebody that does care. But in the same token, he was so happy, free, but we don't know that. It's truly a dilemma for me.